Hello everyone, and welcome back to a brand new quick tip by JANUS Engineering. This time, I would like to show you a better way to pick cut areas in any kind of operation. First of all, let me open up one of these operations. Now, in here, it's going to ask you for wall geometry. I'd like to select all of these faces around this edge, creating a wall. So first we go to cut area, and now I'm supposed to pick all of these faces. I don't want to do this individually. Now if I can avoid this, I'm going to. But how can I do that? Well, I'm going to go up here and I'm going to select tangent faces. When I do this, I'll select just one surface and you'll see all of these are highlighted because they're tangent to one another. Now, I don't necessarily want all of these faces selected. I don't want these top faces selected or the floor geometry. So how can I deselect these? Well, if I hold my shift key down and then I were to go over this top surface here or one of the floors, when I click it, it deselects all of them. So how do I fix this? I'm going to keep this set to tangent faces and then I'm going to reselect all of the surfaces. I'm then going to go into my dialog box, right click in this table, and we're going to use Remove Selection Intent. When I do so, the tangent faces is no longer active, so therefore I can start to deselect those faces. Once more, I will hit the Shift key, and then I can just simply deselect these faces that I don't want to be manufactured. Just like that, I have now selected 133 faces in a glimpse of a time. Simply click on OK, and now I can start to generate the operation. There we go. Now all the wall geometries, including their bottom and top radii, will be manufactured, and the floor and the top of the part won't. I hope this quick tip could help you. And as always, if you have any questions, any comments, any ideas for the next quick tip, just leave them below, and always don't forget to like and subscribe our channel. We'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye-bye.